Hi everyone, welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be doing another surface of revolution problem, and this one is the function y squared equals 4x, and they've asked us to rotate around the x-axis. So the first thing that we need to recognize with these problems is that we're rotating around the x-axis, which means that we're going to be completely ignoring the x variable in our problem. So we're going to leave this totally untouched. We're also going to leave untouched anything outside of the other variables in the problem. So because we're ignoring x and we're leaving everything else alone besides the other variable in the problem, that means we're only looking at the y variable. We'll leave the squared alone and we'll leave 4x alone. So we're going to be looking at y. And here's what we're going to do with it. Keep in mind that with surface of revolution problems, at the end of the problem, you always are going to need to end up with all three variables, x, y, and z. As you can see, we already have both x and y in our problem. So what we need to do is somehow get z into our solution. So remember that we're ignoring x and we're ignoring everything else in the problem. So all you have to work with is y, which means what we're going to do is replace y with y plus z. That's how we add in z to our problem so that we have all three variables at the end. So we're just focusing on y, and what I would recommend doing is building this out in steps is the easiest way to remember so you don't get confused. Write down your y, and you know you need to add in that third variable z, so go ahead and write y plus z in place of y, right? Give yourself some space and just write y plus z. Now you've got all three variables in your problem, x, y, and z. But in this quantity here, what you did when you wrote down y plus z, you still need to square both terms. And this is just part of like the formula for surface of revolution, but you'll square both terms. So you write in the squared term, squared exponent here on the y and on the z. And then you're also going to need to take the square root of that whole quantity. So go ahead and write your square root sign over y squared plus z squared, the whole thing. So that whole quantity right there in parentheses, the quantity square root of y squared plus z squared, that whole thing is what's going to end up replacing just this y variable in our original function. Everything else, the squared term here stays the same, and the 4x stays the same. So you've now set up your solution, and all you have to do to get your final answer is simplify. When you square a square root, obviously the square root goes away, those two things cancel each other out, so you're just left with what's inside your square root, which of course is y squared plus z squared. So you pull that out and you end up for your final answer with y squared plus z squared equals 4x. And that's it. So I hope that helped you guys, and I'll see you in the next video.